Okay, so up to the last class in this quadratic equation, we have seen about the nature of the roots. So in that nature, we have seen about the different conditions about this nature. Now, suppose if there are the two quadratic equations are there. Suppose if there are the two quadratic equations are there, these two quadratic equations maximum they are going to give the four roots. Out of these four roots, how many these are going to give the real roots? How many are the real roots? How many are the complex roots? How do you find this? For finding that, actually we are explaining about this. Suppose if there are the two quadratic equations are there, those are say a1x squared plus b1x plus c1 is equal to 0 is one quadratic equation, and a2x squared plus b2x plus c2 is equal to 0 if it is another quadratic equation. So these are the two quadratic equations are there. Let assume that the discriminant of the first quadratic equation called is the delta 1, that is b1 square minus 4a1 c1. Similarly, say the discriminant of the second quadratic equation is delta 2, that is b2 square minus 4a2 c2. So to find the nature of their roots, we will find the discriminant for the both the quadratic equations. In that, the first case, suppose if delta 1 plus delta 2, the sum of this discriminant is greater than 0. Sum of the discriminants are positive. Then what might be the roots of that equation? To find that, sum of the discriminants are positive. When it is possible, if delta 1, delta 2, delta 1 is positive, delta 2 also positive. If both of them are positive, then their sum is positive only. This is one case, right? So when delta 1 is positive, the discriminant of the first equation, if it is a positive, then we know that this equation is going to give the two distinct real roots. Okay, the roots are real and unequal when the discriminant is positive, right? That we know the condition. That's why if delta 1 is greater than 0, this is going to give the two distinct real roots. And if delta 2 is greater than 0, this is also going to give the two distinct real roots. So therefore, total how many roots it is going to give it? Four distinct real roots this is going to give it. This is one possibility. Or if delta 1 is greater than 0 and delta 2 is less than 0, delta 1 positive, delta 2 negative, and if the delta 1 is bigger than the delta 2, delta 1 is the bigger than the delta 2, even though delta 1 plus delta 2 positive, enough. So this is another condition. So in this case also, there is a possibility that the summation might be positive, right? So if delta 1 positive, matlab, it is going to give two different real roots. And delta 2 is negative means it is not going to give any real root. That's why in this case, out of the four roots, it is going to give the two real roots. Out of these four roots, two are the real root it may represent. Or if delta 1 is negative, delta 2 is positive. Delta 2 negative, delta 1 negative, delta 2 positive. And if the delta 2 is bigger than the delta 1, even though the summation is positive, even though the sum of the discriminant will be positive. That's why in this case also delta 1 negative means it is going to give the two imaginary roots or complex roots. And delta 2 positive means it is going to give the two real roots, means in this case also, it is going to give the two real roots. And the fourth case is that if both are negative, dono bhi negative hai toh, the summation negative hota na? That's why that case is not possible here. That's why this sum of the discriminants are positive, only in these three cases, right? Only in these three cases means out of these four roots, two are the real root or all the four also real root. That's why this is, we can say that at least two real roots, these are going to give it. At least two real roots it is going to give it. Okay. So that is the case of that we have to remember. At least two real roots it may give it. That is a positive. That is the case of that. Okay. Write on that. the two quadratic equation read on this note. The two quadratic equation a1x square plus b1x plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x square plus b2x plus c2 is equal to 0, whose discriminants are delta 1 and delta 2. In that, in the first condition, first case, if delta 1 plus delta 2 greater than 0, if delta 1 plus delta 2 greater than 0, then these equations will have, at least two real roots. Okay, so that is the first case we have to remember. Now look at the second case. Suppose if delta 1 plus delta 2 is less than 0, the sum of the discriminants is negative. Tell me, what is the possibility now? How many what is the nature of that roots?
Unreal.
Complex. Minimum two complex.
At least two complex, because delta 1 plus delta 2 negative. One possibility is that dono bhi negative ho sakta. Delta 1 negative, delta 2 bhi negative hai to bhi delta 1 plus delta 2 negative ho sakta. If this is negative and this is also negative, means this will have the two distinct complex numbers, and this is also going to give the two complex numbers. That's why total it will have the four complex roots. The next case, delta 1 positive, delta 2 negative, and delta 2 is bigger than the delta 1, then this summation is negative. In certain cases also, it will have the two complex roots. And here also, it will have the two complex roots in both the cases. So two complex roots means, what is the condition here? At least these will have the two complex roots. Okay, that is the second condition. Second, if delta 1 plus delta 2 less than 0, delta 1 plus delta 2 less than 0, then the equations will have, at least two complex numbers, Okay, now look at this third case. Suppose the product of the discriminant is negative, when it is possible? This product is negative means, if delta 1 is positive and delta 2 is negative, right? Or delta 1 is negative and delta 2 is positive, then only it is possible, you know? The product is negative means these two should have opposite sign. Then only plus into minus or minus into plus will be the negative, right? That's why the delta 1 positive means it may have the two real roots. Delta 2 is negative means it may have the two complex roots. Or delta 1 negative means the first equation may have the two real complex roots. Delta 2 positive means the second equation may have the two real roots. That's why from this you can analyze that when the product of their discriminant is negative, then these equations will have two real root and two complex roots. Understand? So these equations will have two real root and two complex roots. Okay, that is the third case. if delta 1 into delta 2 less than 0, if delta 1 into delta 2 less than 0, then the equations will have, then the equations will have two real and two complex roots. Then the equations will have two real and two complex roots. Now look at the fourth case. Suppose delta 1 into delta 2 greater than 0. This product of the discriminant is positive. Now tell me how many, what are the nature of their roots?
Sir, both may be negative or both may be positive.
So both may be negative. If both are negative, then how many roots, what is the nature of the roots?
All complex.
All complex. And if both are positive?
All real roots.
Means, so here the possibility is that it may have the all the four are the complex roots or all four are the real roots. Okay, there is a condition for that. And in this fourth case, if delta 1 into delta 2 greater than 0, delta 1 into delta 2 greater than 0, then the equations will have, then the equations will have, then the equations will have all four are positive, real, all four real roots are all four are complex roots. All four are the real roots are all four are complex roots. Okay. So this is the conditions that we have to remember. Now, give this somebody common root. Give this somebody common root. Now, look at this. What is meant by this common root? Means, suppose if there are the two equations are there, a1x square plus b1x plus c1 is equal to 0 and a2x square plus b2x plus c2 is equal to 0. Suppose if these two equations has one root in common, one root in common, then what is that common root? Then what is the condition for having the common root? Means actually it is going to represent the two roots and it is also going to give the two roots. So out of these two roots and out of these two roots, if one root in common, that is suppose for example, suppose the roots of the first equation say alpha and beta, the root of the second equation say alpha and gamma, let us assume that. I will take that root of the first equation say alpha and beta, root of the second equation say alpha and gamma, means for both of them, alpha is the common root. Alpha is the root for both the equations, that is required as a common root. So for these both the equations, suppose exactly one root only in common, one root only, not both the roots, only one root in common, then what is that common root and what is the condition for finding the common root? That we will see that. So just look at that. Suppose these two equations has a common root. Let assume that alpha is that common root. Let assume that alpha is the common root of this, okay? If alpha is the common root, means this should be the root of the first equation and as well as the second equation also. Alpha will be the root of the first equation and as well as the second equation also, right? If it is the root of the first equation, it has to satisfy the first equation. So therefore, substitute the alpha in this equation, that is a1 alpha square plus b1 alpha plus c1 is equal to 0 and alpha also should satisfy the second equation because alpha is also root of the second equation. So substitute alpha in the second equation, then we are getting that a2 alpha square plus b2 alpha plus c2 is equal to 0. So alpha will satisfy both the equations. We'll substitute alpha in both of them. Okay. Now if you solve these two equations, we can find the value of the alpha. Right? For solving the equations, simultaneous linear equations you are aware about from your 9th class onwards, how to solve the equations. For solving the equations, we have the different methods. One is the elimination method. Second one is substitution method.
Cross multiplication.
Cross multiplication method. Okay. Now we will go for that cross multiplication method. As for the cross multiplication method, we will modify a little bit for our convenience. What we will do is, first I will write the coefficient of the middle term. Coefficient of the middle term for the first equation, that is the B1. Then write the constant, that is called the C1. Then write the coefficient of the first term, that is A1. Again, the coefficient of the middle term, that is B1. Okay? First, we'll write the coefficient of the middle term, constant, coefficient of the first term, then the coefficient of the middle term for the first equation. Similarly, write in the same order for the second equation. B2, C2, A2,
A2.
Okay, like that, we'll write the middle term, constant, first term, and middle term again. Now, here the first variable is alpha square. That's what this is. We'll write that alpha square upon. Second variable here, it is alpha. That is alpha upon. Yes, third one, it is the constant means that is, we'll write 1 upon. Like that, we will write it. Now, we will do the cross multiplication here. We'll do the cross multiplication. So this is, you can write that alpha square upon. If you do the cross multiplication, this is, we are getting B1 C2 minus B2 C1. B1 C2 minus B2 C1 is equal to second one, alpha upon. Here, do the cross multiplication. C1 A2 minus C2 A1. C1 A2 minus C2 A1 is equal to 1 upon, here this constant is A1 B2 minus A2 B1. A1 B2 minus A2 B1. Understand? So like that we have to write it. Means you have to write the coefficient in the middle term, constant, coefficient of the first term, again middle term for the first equation. Similarly, write down for the second equation also. First, write down alpha square upon, do the cross multiplication here, B1 C2 minus B2 C1 is equal to alpha upon C1 A2 minus C2 A1 is equal to 1 upon A1 B2 minus A2 B1. Okay, like that we'll write it. Now we will equate this one and this one. We will equate these two, and if you do the cross multiplication, then we are getting that alpha is equal to C1 A2 minus C2 A1 upon A1 B2 minus A2 B1. So this is the common root of that equation. Okay? If you equate karo, cross multiplication karo, then this denominator goes to the numerator other side. There is a C1 A2 minus C2 A1 upon A1 B2 minus A2 B1. That is the common root for both the equations. Understand? You see, the two roots will have the common root. Then that common root is C1 A2 minus C2 A1 upon A1 B2 minus A2 B1. That we have to remember. And what is the condition to have the common root? For that, equate this first one and the last one. Equate the first one and the last one. If you equate these two, that I will write here, then we are getting that alpha square is equal to, do the cross multiplication, B1 C2 minus B2 C1 upon A1 B2 minus A2 B1. This is the value of the alpha square. Okay. Now, we know the value of the alpha is this much. Substitute this alpha in this. Alpha square means that is C1 A2 minus C2 A1 whole square upon A1 B2 minus A2 B1 whole square is equal to B1 C2 minus B2 C1 upon A1 B2 minus A2 B1. Now on both the sides, this denominator one time is getting cancelled. Then do the cross multiplication that I'm going to write here. So therefore, the condition is that C1 A2 minus C2 A1 whole square is equal to B1 C2 minus B2 C1 into A1 B2 minus A2 B1. Okay, so this is the condition that we have to remember. Right. Means if the two equations have a common root, have a one root in common, then this is the condition. C1 A2 minus C2 A1 whole square is equal to A1 B2 minus A2 B1 into B1 C2 minus B2 C1. And the common root is that C1 A2 minus C2 A1 by A1 B2 minus A2 B1, it is the common root. Okay. So this formula and as well as this formula we have to remember. Okay. So write this note.
Sir, please explain it once again.
Okay. Just look at
sir,
this.
Sir, from that alpha square.
From this, okay. Now, this is the relation now, we got it. Now here, equal sir, is first that one upper and the one last one. Alpha square. Yeah? Any doubt? So here, equate this first one and the last one. And if you do the cross multiplication, then alpha square is equal to this denominator comes to the numerator. That is B1 C2 minus B2 C1 upon A1 B2 minus A2 B1. But where alpha value, we got this one. This is alpha value. Keep this alpha value in this. Then alpha square means C1 A2